Pray, brethren, that my sacrifice and yours may be acceptable to God, the Almighty Father.
May the Lord accept the sacrifice at your hands, for the praise and glory of his name, of our good and good of all his holy church.
Be pleased, O Lord, with these sacrificial offerings, and grant that we who beseech pardon for our sins may take care to forgive our neighbor. Through Christ our Lord.
Amen.
Dominus vobiscum.
Et cum spiritu tuo.
Solus in cordam.
Adeus ad hominum.
Gratias agamus. Domino Deo nostro,
dignus et curus tuas.
It is truly right and just, our duty and our salvation, always and everywhere to give you thanks, Lord, Holy Father, Almighty, Eternal God, through Christ our Lord. For when he asked the Samaritan woman for water to drink, he had already created the gift of faith within her, and so ardently did he thirst for her faith that he kindled in her the fire of divine love. And so we too give you thanks, and with the angels praise your almighty deeds as we acclaim.
Sanctus, 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 Dominus Deus Sanctus.
Yeah. most merciful Father, we make humble prayer and petition through Jesus Christ, your Son, our Lord, that you accept and bless these gifts, these offerings, these holy and unblemished sacrifices, which we offer you firstly for your holy Catholic Church. Be pleased to grant her peace, to guard, unite, and govern her throughout the whole world. Together with your servant Francis, our Pope, and Robert, our Bishop, and all those who hold to the truth and on the Catholic and Apostolic faith. Remember, Lord, your servants. And all gathered here as faith and devotion are known to you. For them we offer you this sacrifice of praise, or they offer it for themselves and all who are dear to them, for the redemption of their souls and hope of health and well-being, and paying their homage to you, the eternal God, living and true. In communion with those whose memory we venerate, especially the glorious ever-Virgin Mary, Mother of our God and Lord Jesus Christ, and Blessed Joseph, her spouse, your blessed apostles and martyrs, Peter and Paul, Andrew, James, John, Thomas, James, Philip, Bartholomew, Matthew, Simon, and Jude, Linus, Cletus, Clement, Sixtus, Cornelius, Cyprian, Lawrence, Chrysogonus, John and Paul, Cosmas and Damian, and all your saints, we ask that through their merits and prayers, in all things we may be defended by your protecting help. Therefore, Lord, we pray, graciously accept this oblation of our service, that of your whole family, order our days in your peace, and command that we be delivered from eternal damnation and counted among the flock of those you have chosen. Be pleased, O God, we pray, to bless, acknowledge, and approve this offering in every respect. Make it spiritual and acceptable, so that it may become for us the body and blood of your most beloved Son, our Lord Jesus Christ. On the day before he was to suffer, he took bread in his holy and venerable hands, with eyes raised to heaven to you, O God, his almighty Father. Giving you thanks, he said the blessing, broke the bread, and gave it to his disciples, saying, "Take this, all of you, and eat of it, for this is my body, which will be given up for you." Supper was ended, he took this precious chalice in his holy and venerable hands, and once more giving you thanks, he said the blessing, and gave the chalice to his disciples, saying, "Take this, all of you, and drink from it, for this is the chalice of my blood, the blood of the new and eternal covenant, which will be poured out for you and for many for the forgiveness of sins. Do this in memory of me." Into heaven of Christ your Son our Lord, we your servants and your holy people offer to your glorious majesty from the gifts that you have given us this pure victim, this holy victim, this spotless victim, the holy bread of eternal life and the chalice of everlasting salvation. Be pleased to look upon these offerings with a serene and kindly countenance, and to accept them as once you are pleased to accept the gifts of your servant Abel the Just, the sacrifice of Abraham, our father in faith, and the offering of your high priest Melchizedek, a holy sacrifice, a spotless victim. In humble prayer, we ask you, Almighty God, command that these gifts be borne by the hands of your holy angel to your altar on high in the sight of your divine majesty, so that all of us who through this participation at the altar receive the most holy body and blood of your Son may be filled with every grace and heavenly blessing. Remember also, Lord, your servants who have gone before us with a sign of faith and rest in the sleep of peace. Grant them, O Lord, we pray, and all who sleep in Christ, a place of refreshment, light, and peace. To us also, your servants, who those sinners hope in your abundant mercies, graciously grant some share and fellowship with your holy apostles and martyrs, with John the Baptist, Stephen, Matthias, Barnabas, Ignatius, Alexander, Marcellinus, Peter, Felicity, Perpetua, Agatha, Lucy, Agnes, Cecilia, Anastasia, and all your saints. Admit us, we beseech you, into their company, not weighing our merits, but granting us your pardon through Christ our Lord, through whom you continue to make all these good things, O Lord, you sanctify them, fill them with life, bless them, and bestow them upon us. Per ipsum ecum ipso et in ipso est Deo Patri omnipotenti in unitate Spiritus Sancti omnis honor et gloria per omnia saecula saeculorum.
Amen.
Recepti salutaribus moniti et in institutione formati audemus dicere.
Pater noster, qui es in celis, sanctificetur nomen tuum, adveniat regnum tuum, fiat voluntas tua, sicut in cielo et in terra. Panem nostrum quotidianum da nobis hodie, et imite nobis debita nostra, sicut et nos dimittimus debitoribus nostris.
Propitius pacem in diibus nostris, ut obe misericordiae te adiuti, et avocatus in nos semper liberi, et ab omni perturbatione securi, expectantes beatam spem, ad adventum salvatoris nostri, Iesu Christi.
Qui
existio postulis tuis, pacem rea in quo vobis, pacem meam do vobis, ne respicias peccata nostra, sed finem ecclesiae tue, eamque secundum voluntatem tuam, pacificare et quadenare dimieris, qui vivis et regnas in saecula saeculorum. Semper vobiscum.
Et cum spiritu tuo. Agnus Dei qui tollis peccatus meus. Thank you.
Ecce Agnus Dei, ecce qui tollit peccata mundi, beati qui aeternum agni vocati sunt, Domine non sunt ignis, prudentia est attecta mea, sed tantum dic verbo, et senabitur anima mea. Drinks it, says the Lord, the water I shall give will become in him a spring welling up to eternal life.
Who cannot now receive Jesus in the Blessed Sacrament, we offer the following prayer. My good Lord, my dear Jesus, I am sorry for having wounded thy loving heart by my sins, because thou art infinitely good, and sin displeases thee. Like the beloved disciple, let me rest upon thy heart, and let me grieve together with thee for the outrages that are committed against thee in this sacrament of thy love. I give thee my heart and my love, if my poor love can comfort thee. I love thee above all things, and I desire to possess thee within my soul. Since I am unable now to receive thee sacramentally, come at least spiritually into my heart, and nourish my soul unto life everlasting. Let my soul, O Lord, feel thy sweetness. Let me taste how sweet thou art, O Lord, that being allured by thy love, I may never sin by running after worldly pleasures. Thou art the God of my heart, and the God that is my portion forever. O thou Lamb of God, who takest away the sins of the world, take away from me whatever may hurt me and displease thee. Give me thy love and thy grace. May the sweet flame of thy love consume my soul, that I may die to the world for the love of thee, as thou hast died upon the cross for the love of me. Amen.
Thank you.
receive the pledge of things yet hidden in heaven, and are nourished while still on earth with the bread that comes from on high. We humbly entreat you, O Lord, that what is being brought about in us in mystery may come to true completion through Christ our Lord.
Amen.
The Lord be with you.
And with your spirit.
Bow down for the blessing. Direct, O Lord, we pray, the hearts of your faithful, and in your kindness grant your servants this grace, that abiding in love of you and of their neighbor, they may fulfill the whole of your commands through Christ our Lord.
Amen.
And may the blessing of Almighty God, the Father, and the Son, and the Holy Spirit come down on you and remain with you forever.
Oh. presents the following special program.
Timothy O'Donnell, and I welcome you to this Roman pilgrimage where we are examining the Lenten stational churches of Rome. Today we will be going to a very interesting church. It'll take us outside the walls of the ancient city as we go to San Lorenzo Fiore le Mura, St. Lawrence, outside the walls. This basilica, which we're visiting on this Sunday in Lent, is the actual site where St. Lawrence himself, along with St. Stephen, happens to be buried. This visit to the tomb on a Sunday of such a great saint is important for us, and the Church urges us at this time to reflect upon the importance of praying for the dead. Praying for the dead is a great act of charity. A lot of times today, if you go to a funeral, you'll often be surprised when you'll find that there's a great eulogy given to the person who has died, almost as if you're witnessing a canonization. The traditional wisdom of the Church urges us to avoid such things, particularly at funeral masses. And when we think of the dead, recognize the fact that human nature being what it is, there are a lot of imperfections in every individual human being. And so the Church, in her maternal solicitude, urges us to pray for the dead. In the wake of the Second Vatican Council, some people thought that the Church had dropped her doctrine of purgatory. Nothing could be further from the truth. And it's clearly stated and reaffirmed once again in the Catholic Catechism. So as we go to the tomb of the martyr St. Lawrence, we think also of the countless dead who were buried nearby. The ancient Roman cemetery of Campo Verano, where all of the Romans were buried down through the centuries, is frequently visited, particularly on All Souls Day, by the Roman faithful, where they pray for their beloved dead. We also, in imitation of them, should call to mind during this Lenten season, as a special act of charity, our beloved departed, those who have gone on. Through our prayers, we can lessen the time that they spend in purgatory, hoping that through our prayers they can leave behind those flames of purgatory and hasten to the day when they will be perfectly united with their loving Lord. As we go outside the walls of the ancient city to the Church of San Lorenzo, let us think of all our loved ones who have gone on to be with the Lord, and let us pray with fervent hearts during this Lenten season that they may be one with Him. So let us go to the Church of San Lorenzo Fiore le Mura. This is one of the most fascinating churches architecturally and historically. It is one of the seven great ancient basilicas of Rome that were part of the famous medieval pilgrimage. It is also one of the most beautiful and popular, certainly, with the native Romans. This is probable because most of their relatives are buried in the nearby cemetery. The basilica, which is dedicated to St. Lawrence the Deacon and martyr, was roasted alive on a gridiron in the year 258. And was buried in what was called the Argo Verano along the Via Tiburtina. The use of this particular basilica as a stational church during Lent can be traced back to the 4th century. St. Lawrence was declared to be a patriarchal basilica by Pope Leo the Great, who reigned as pontiff from 440 to 461. And this was assigned as the Roman residence for the Patriarch of Jerusalem. The present church is of great interest because it is actually composed of three originally distinct buildings. The western half, which forms the present nave, is the basilica that was built by Pope Sixtus III, who reigned from 432 to 440. It is a church of great antiquity. When one enters the church, the sense of stepping back into the ancient times can be an overwhelming experience. The eastern half, which is presently serving as the chancel, was the basilica that was built by Pope Pelagius II, who reigned from 579 to 590. This basilica originally had faced to the east,
In this part of the church, there are 10 beautiful fluted marble columns with Corinthian capitals. These support the architrave, which is made of delicate Roman carving, obviously taken from a variety of ancient Roman buildings. They are surprisingly disparate. The original